thinking, because what I'm thinking is what I saw, and what I saw is what I'm thinking, and I don't have a damn answer. So I'm lost. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, it's got to be something. I got it. Something got to give. Something got to shake it. So
I said, what I'm thinking is what I thought. What I'm thinking is what I'm thinking.
Yeah, what I saw is what I'm thinking, what I saw, but I saw what I was thinking, but I just still don't have the answers. You see what I'm saying? So, yeah,
Okay.
We're going to dive into that one. We're going to figure that out.
The boy G said his computer is loading back up. You know what I'm saying? I started recording already. I know the people see us. I'm not starting the podcast right now, but I think we can no longer be Will Smith, man. While I'm looking at you right now, you know what I'm saying? Let your camera get back on focus.
Oh, what happened?
I think you more Tech Nine now. You got to be Tech Nine now. I gotta find somebody else to join up on the Will Smith tip.
What do you got, three or four? What do you? I don't know.
I know that nigga got, man.
That nigga got a couple though. You know what I'm talking about? That nigga got a couple. There we go. Hold on. I got you. Yeah. Yeah. There we go, baby.
That boy Tech Nine for real. That boy look just like Tech Nine over there.
That way they can see it against my skin complexion. Yeah, trying to set the fuck out of here.
Yeah, man. That's a new one right there, you heard? Man.
Oh, man, boy.
Anyway, let's start this thing up. Greg said he going to get in here when he get in here. You know what I'm talking about?
What's up?
Welcome to the MVP.
The Man's View Podcast, baby.
Yeah, we back here another time, man. For another again. Before we start this podcast off, I'm currently in a situation. Have you ever wanted something? They have these little arcade things of the old Ninja Turtle arcade game. They actually got the arcade set up for it. And I'll post a picture in there, you know what I'm saying? So everybody can see what this looks like. And, you know, the partner Travis, he was like, yeah, they range anywhere from $99 to $200. I said, oh, that's doable. I might get me one. I put it in the man cave, you heard me? I'll be straight. You know, I'm a Ninja Turtle fan. And then I look it up online, they say $400. And I was like, well, that ain't $200 or $99. So I asked the brother, where they at for the $100? And the brother still has not replied to me. It's going on by 20 minutes, and we was actively in conversation. And when I looked it up, online, I sent it back, and I said, man, I can't pay the phone, and that's what they say online. And he's like, nah, it ranged from 100 to 200, and I haven't seen the 100 yet nowhere. Wow. And then Darrell was like, well, my cousin Gene work at Walmart. He said they 400 over here at this Walmart, and Travis still hasn't hit us back with any kind of where the 99 price at. You know what I'm saying? So it's all right. I posted it here. It's like a little arcade, like the old arcade system, the Ninja Turtles. They got it where you can have it at your house now. It's clean.
Big job.
Selling them for $400. Yeah, it's nice. Big thing and all that with the joystick and all that shit. You know what I'm saying? So I would like to buy it, but I ain't paying the full for it. You heard? I ain't doing that. Huh?
I don't need coins. I don't need quarters to play.
Now, you don't need quarters to play. You just press start. You get unlimited men. You know what I'm talking about? Just keep on going.
Yeah. Unlimited. Okay, unlimited. Yeah, all right. I'm with that.
You pay for them goddamn quarters. You pay $400 for that shit. Yeah.
Damn. Damn it. It better be free. I'd be damned if I. Yeah.
Man. But anyway, but
that's the best thrill you ever had in your life. Thank you.
There you go, Soup. Knock his head off. You heard me?
No, you do not. Crazy.
Yo, before we get into stuff, man, whatever happened to the weirdo downstairs, man? Y'all ever caught that nigga?
Nah, I didn't get there. I didn't make it in time. Bless his heart. Mm-hmm. Like I said, I was just trying to put face the note. And, yeah.
You ain't catch the face yet?
Nah, I had just missed partner. Okay. Yeah, I had just missed.
Don't go down there Superman punching nobody. You heard me? We don't need all that.
Yeah, no. I'm gonna hit him with what's the movie? What's the show we watching? Dudes with the special abilities right now.
Raising Dion, is that what you talking about?
The who?
Never mind. They,
no, the one that you told me to watch with the knockoff Wonder Woman, Superman, but they bad.
The Boys.
The Boys, yes. The Boys. The Boys. Yeah. About to be out here A-training motherfuckers. You know what I'm talking about? Nick can't stop. I couldn't stop. Yeah, you don't want that.
Don't do that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. We don't want you to leave somebody with just their hands, man. That's some bullshit.
You know what I'm talking about? Yeah. Yeah, we ain't going to do that.
Well, the boy G still ain't here. He restarting his computer. So let's go into the inspirational person of the week. And I have it. It is Tyler Perry.
Tyler Perry, y'all. Okay.
Tyler Perry. I know you seen it in our book. You saw it?
Yeah, I saw that before you even posted it in the group chat. Or whoever posted, I think it was you. But I had actually, I had saw it. I had already seen it. I was like, okay, I'm going to talk about it. I was going to highlight him my damn self. Yeah. I was like, okay. Book don't usually find niggas because I don't be caring what motherfuckers doing. You know what I'm talking about, first and foremost. Uh-huh. But I know there's other people out in the world who do. But uh-huh. I saw that, and I think I watched a little video on it. I wonder if it's the same thing. The one that I saw was he had bought pretty much bought an old army base or military installation and turned it into housing for and all this other stuff. Is that the same thing?
Exact same thing.
So I was going to big him up on that one. Mm-hmm. I was going to big him up on that. Like, I think that's a dope move, reinvesting your money back into your community, mm-hmm. you know, first and foremost. So even if it wasn't a doggone studio and you just did it like that, residential housing, like, bruh, I'd have commended you for that. But I love to see, you know, this Black empowerment movement, especially from him, you know what I mean? So that's big, man. A lot of people talk about it, but don't be about it. But mm-hmm. Yeah, put his money where his mouth is on that one.
There's a couple things I like that he did, man. It was so huge. It was an old Confederate Army base. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
That he took. And he's made different sound sets. He literally, there's the White House on that property. You saw the White House?
Mm-hmm.
That shit was dope. Like, you got to see it. If y'all didn't see it, go on somebody's page. I know Charlamagne was there. Matter of fact, everybody was there. Oprah. Anybody, they was all there at that place, knocking it off. Also, he named different sound sets after different people, you know what I'm saying? Okay. So that was real dope. He had the Will Smith sound set. They broke the wine bottle about that. Him and Spike Lee had got into it. Matter of fact, he didn't even get into it. Spike Lee was talking shit about Tyler Perry back in the day. But showing the kind of dude that Tyler Perry is, he got over. He was the bigger man. And he actually named a sound set after him, after Spike Lee. There's a Spike Lee sound set over at the Tyler Perry. To me, I think that's big balling. You heard me? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, hey, I got the last laugh out of everything. That's just how petty I am. That's how I feel. But I know Tyler Perry. He did it off some real shit. What they had all kind of people, man. It was just dope. They had the Oprah sound set. They had every kind of inspirational person to him. It was real dope. So shout out to Tyler Perry. I thought that was real smooth. I like how you're doing things, and that's real inspirational. If you can't get inspiration off that, it's nothing that would inspire you. You heard. Bong, 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 bong.
The bumba clock out of Rasta. Take the watch and lead the what? That's from Shottas.
Yours is way better than mine.
Shottas, Jamaican. Yeah.
Your shots is way better than my bong. There we go. Okay. Now, you know we go to the bullshit of the week. We're going to leave excellence and we're going to go to some bullshit. Okay.
Talk about it.
I'm gonna try to get the hard shit out of the way first. I know it's the second week in a row we're talking about this Amber Geiger case. The only reason we're bringing it up now is one of the key people that testified against Amber Geiger in that case turned up dead this week. Joshua Brown, he was killed, and supposedly the cops came out with the whole story, and they said that this guy was in a drug deal going bad. What you say? You went mute on me. I can't hear you.
Yeah, I did that on purpose.
Okay, I was like, what happened to you?
I thought you could still hear me, though. I was like, no, I hit mute.
I just see your mouth moving, and I couldn't see nothing. But anyway.
Okay, you saw my mouth.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Oh, all right, all right.
But anyway, we go back to Joshua Brown being killed. They said it was a drug deal going bad. They said three dudes drove from Louisiana all the way to Texas, all the way to Dallas to do a drug deal over 12 pounds of weed. I don't know how feasible or how that makes sense. Maybe they just had the best rates going on in the county or in the state. I have no idea. To me, when it comes to the police, I am very skeptical. So I'm going to call some bullshit on that story right there. Book, I don't know if you heard about this. You got anything you want to say about it?
I ain't heard no shit like that in my life.
Yeah, man. Dude, Joshua Brown testified against Amber Geiger, and then a couple of days later, turned up dead.
I think it was her partner.
Very well could be. I'm not going to say no who it was or who it wasn't was, but I would say I don't think it was those three guys from Louisiana just came up there and killed
suspect. Them. I'll tell you that.
And if they, you know what I'm saying? And if they did it, if OJ did it, then somebody paid them to do it too. I don't know. Man, I think, look, I'm going to be real with you about this OJ thing. Sidebar from the bullshit of the week. Matter of fact, this is still in the bullshit category. They were so on that OJ did it. I don't have a doubt that OJ has something to do with it.
I don't think he physically did it.
You know what I'm saying? That was the whole thing. And this is what I think is the same kind of case. I won't put it past these guys that they didn't do it, but I ain't gonna put it past the police department to say they had a hand in it either. You know what I'm saying?
You talking about they Juicy Smollett?
Yeah, I think they might have been a little bit of that. Yeah.
How Dave Chappelle said it? God dog it.
Juicy Smollett. Yeah.
Juicy Smollett, French accent.
Man. But I had to get that bullshit out first, man. Let's go and move on from that bullshit because, this whole Amber Geiger thing is still killing me.
They need to let that just...
Man, it's hard for me to get over that, but I'm going to leave that alone. The only reason I'm going to leave it alone because the parents, not the parents, but the daddy want to be her friend now too when she get out. So, hey, it is what it is.
Yeah, please.
That's what he said. So, hey, then y'all handle that y'all own self. Then y'all know y'all son better than I know. So if he that forgiven, then I can't mess with y'all. Anyway, next topic. We have a thing from Florida. We have a DeAndre Somerville was sentenced to 10 days in jail. I don't know if y'all saw this. For missing jury duty. you wanna tell this story, Book?
I vaguely saw it. I didn't read it too much. So the in-depth, you know what I'm saying, about the mishap, I really don't know. I just saw that the boy was in prison and then he was let out. So I'm just like, I didn't know jury duty was a crime. You know what I mean? Like there's real shit that people should be in prison for, yet you out here because people, like, come on, man. And I thought it was a black guy. Now, if it was a white guy, I wouldn't really care. Or a white woman. Or any other nationality. Any other race. I wouldn't care, man. But it just looks so bad when you're just locking up black people, period. You know what I'm saying? Especially for the petty shit. So that's really all I had to say about that. Like, I didn't know jury duty was that important that you couldn't do without me for a day.
Well, you know what I'm saying? When they asked the judge basically said he locked him up because he was black, because he represented a cross section in this community that needed to be represented, and he was the only black person on the jury. That's why he locked him up. Didn't make sense. But that's what he said. He had to read a statement out in court saying how he apologized. The judge let him out and then sentenced him to probation for that bullshit. After it went viral, Charlamagne gave the courts donkey of the day and the judge donkey of the day. They vacated everything, and the man is now free and able to live his life the right way. This is somebody who's never been to jail, who's never had an incident with the law, and all of a sudden missed a jury duty day and ended up in jail for 10 days with probation.
I got one for you.
If that ain't some bullshit, I don't know what it is. Yes, sir. What you got?
because you brought up the black person. So I don't know. I don't post like that when shit happens. I just be seeing it at work for the most part. And sometimes I'll remember it. Sometimes I don't. But you since it was recent, my spider senses was tingling. You know what I'm talking about? It was tingling. So did you hear about the lawsuit for the Hilton, the DoubleTree?
Nah, whatever.
Yeah, there's this black brother. He is suing that hotel establishment $10 million. The reason being, happened in Seattle, Oregon, somewhere up there. Where. The dude is Jermaine Massey, okay? Mm-hmm. And there was a video that went out, like, viral, I guess. He recorded it a while back. And pretty much he was a guest at the hotel, had a room and all that, okay? He was downstairs in the lobby talking on the phone, talking to his mother at that. Police officer or security guard comes up to him and says, sir, you need to get off the phone. So he's like, I'm talking to my mother. She's sick. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And he was like, pretty much, he don't care. He was like, well, you're disturbing the other guests in this establishment. He was like, do you have a room here? Can I see your key card? So he pulls it out, shows him the key card. Next thing you know, he's like, well, what room number are you in?
It don't even matter. I show you
a key card. Exactly. I have a key card. Yeah. Exactly. So he was like, what room number are you in? He was like, I don't remember. He was like, I know how to get to my room. You know what I'm saying? So the guy was like, well, long story short, they told that brother he gonna have to leave. He need to leave. That's that. Yeah, already paid for. Got my key card. I'm already set up in my room. I'm just taking a phone conversation in the lobby, talking to my mother. You know what I mean? Mm. Who he says in his lawsuit that she's ill. But yeah, the DoubleTree Hilton kicked that boy up out of there. Kicked him up out of there, swift, with no regret. So afterwards, you know, of course, you know, people, now that that lawsuit is booming and popping, I wish a motherfucker would kick me out. But I call bullshit on that, because with all of the hypocrisy going on, man, like, you had to know that this was unjust. You know what I'm saying? Yet you did it anyway. Now, I could see if the brother was just in there, you know, trying to get out of the rain because he was walking and have a car, and he was like, sir, you know, you're not conducting business on this establishment grounds, then you know, unfortunately, you're considered trespassing. But yeah, they told that brother, we don't care that you got a room key. We don't care. Okay, yeah, I escort you to your room. I see that your stuff is here. Yeah, grab that and get out. Like, my nigga, what? Bullshit.
That's some bullshit.
Hope he get every penny.
How much he suing for?
Microsoft. Huh?
How much he suing for?
$10 million. $10 million.
He went too low. He should have started with 50.
I would have started a little bit higher, too. That's a big I'd have started a little bit higher, too. I'd have put another zero on that. $100 million, nigga. Exactly. How much you want to settle? Cool. You know what I'm saying?
I would have started with $50 million. And my mama is perfectly fine. Fuck him. Fuck him. You know what I'm saying? And then I'm going to put a separate suit in on a security guard. Fuck him, too.
The security guard is listed as a defendant. Mm-hmm. And the actual person that was on duty that called for him to come over, that security guard. You see what I'm saying? Because even though that the employee told the security guard to come, the security guard should have had better judgment. So yeah, I'm put you in this lawsuit as well. Mm-hmm. But it's $3 million for frustration, humiliation, and feelings of racial stigmatization. And then also the other $7 million is for punitive damages. So, yep. I said, man, go on and get him. Of course, you know, Hilton, DoubleTree, they said, hit him with the Starbucks treatment. Yeah, we've already sent, you know, everybody to class and all of that. You don't need a class to be taught human decency, first of all.
First off, this is what I'm going to tell people. I don't like when they offend somebody and then tell that person what I'm going to do. They never ask, hey, what is going to make you feel better? They always say, nah, we're going to just do this shit. That nigga don't care about that shit. You played me that day. So you know what? Then I want that paper. Fuck what you talking about. But I think he should have started at, like how you said, 100 million, and then we could have settled down at a 10. he started too low, man. You know what I'm saying? Hey, he gonna end up at a million. Nah.
He's gonna end up with just 2.5 or 2 million. You ain't lying.
You gotta pay taxes on that, nigga. Come on.
And then after that, nigga, $900,000. Yeah, like, nigga, it wasn't even worth it. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, man. I still wanna be a millionaire after my lawsuit. You know what I'm saying? That's the point.
You gotta pay your lawyer fees, all that. Come on, the court fees. Come on, brother. Let's get it together. Anyway, that is definitely some bullshit. The last bullshit that I got is Errol Spence. You know who Errol Spence is, the boxer? Definitely. He was in a car accident. I thought it was some bullshit. Just because he was in a car accident. They have the video and everything online about his Ferrari flipping over. You see it flip over and all that. You see him get ejected out the vehicle. I'm glad there's no broken bones, anything like that. They said he's on the road to good recovery, but that was some bullshit when I first heard it earlier in the week and we didn't know his status. So definitely thank God for him. Hopefully he can get back to his stature in the ring. We just saw him fight one of the best fights of all time, especially this year. I'm not going to say all time, but of this year, he fought the best fight of this year, him and Sean Porter. So, yeah, we want to send prayers up to that and make sure he get a speedy recovery and make sure he hasn't lost a step. Shout out to Errol Spence right there in Dallas.
Okay. All right. Well, while we waiting, I just want to take this time out to drop a little ad, give a little in-house commercial to my boy AD, Luke Cage. Shout out to the boy. Always got your boy looking fresh. Got him looking so clean. You see what I'm saying? Dope music. Hold up. Get it together. Dope music. Chosen musicians. All right. For those of you who don't know, you can go online and get your supply. He got beanies, hoodies, t-shirts, tanks for not only just the fellas, but for the ladies too. So go on and support that boy. You know what I'm talking about? I'm sorry. Support the God. All right. Support that man. Don't forget to support us also. You know what I'm talking about? We got MVP merch as well, baby. You know, you get the link at the end of the video. You know who to hit up, baby. You can get it in any color that you like. Okay? That's my commercial.
It's about to be fake as fuck. Yo, Greg, welcome to the podcast. Even though you've been here about 20 minutes now, people ain't gonna see the shit we was talking about.
My bad, man. We had some stuff to address. That's all. We straight though.
Yo. Hey, that's the best way I can say it without being too phony, man.
Good, perfect. Yo,
Greg is on now. You know, Greg, go ahead. I don't want to do that shit. So, hey.
Yeah, we got to keep it real, man.
Hey, it is what it is. Shoot, shout out to everybody in the podcast world.
Yes, sir.
It's topic time, man. Just go to topics, book. What you got, bro?
You know, we talk about...
I forgot.
Whatever.
First thing. One thing before. I'm sorry. I apologize. Great this money. Was supposed to be in the bullshit portion of the segment. Shout out to Marquita. Y'all remember Marquita. Marquita had a question talking about what we put in our cups when we drink. Marquita, I'm telling you this. I'm looking straight in the camera. That's my motherfucking business. But I put in my goddamn
I was really gonna tell.
I don't know what this nigga's got.
This nigga drinking water. Don't worry about what Greg drinking. Greg drinking communion juice right now. Nigga, great Kool-Aid.
You know what I'm saying?
My bad, but go ahead and go to the topic, but go ahead, bruh.
Y'all know when I'm drinking something, I'm a whole different type of animal, boy. Woo, that fountain get to running, goddamn it. But, shit, man, we was talking about, you know, I know we talked on grooming before, but, you know, as a man, me personally, you know what I'm saying, I like to get manicures and pedicures. I don't think that makes me soft or sensitive. it makes my hands and my skin sensitive to touch my woman's body. You feel what I'm saying? I think they appreciate that, you know, the lack of hangnails and shit like that. You know what I'm talking about? Like, you got to get them bitches glossy. So I want to take it above and beyond. You know what I'm talking about? I want to take it a step further. Now, we know as for our ladies, you know, they go through this routine, rigorous and vigorous, of beautifying themselves for their lover, for their spouse, for the other partner. You know, getting their hair done, nails done, just like everybody else. You know what I'm talking about? They go the extra mile of getting waxed and all of that, okay? To please you. I know it's painful. I know it's painful. We've all seen 40-year-old virgin when a nigga trying to get his chest waxed. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Oh, Kelly Clark.
Yeah. Yeah,
so what I want to know is, as much as the fellas, and y'all spoke on this on the cruise front, you, Travis, and Mike, y'all said it. You know, y'all was enamored and thrilled with, you know, how that Brazilian wax comes into life, okay? Mm-hmm. But what if your wife wanted you to get yourself waxed? I'm talking about in your John Hines parts, okay? Ain't talking about your underarms, your legs, or your arms, your mustache, nothing like that. I'm talking about your groin area. What if she said, baby, I want that smooth baby bottom. I need you to wax that. Let me see what that's like. Let me see if it make a difference. You know what I'm talking about? And I don't even want to put the pressure on just your wife. Say just in your life, okay, if that's a better context for you. But we all together with somebody, so of course we're going to talk about what we are now, current stature. Now, like I said, are you willing to do that? Or if you're not willing to go to a place, would you let your wife do it for you?
Talk to me nice! Wait, hold up. Before we answer, I feel like there's a story attached to this. I need to know the story attached to this question. Yeah, from you, nigga.
The story for me, but I don't want it to be jaded by y'all's answers.
Okay, no problem. We'll answer first.
Yeah, I don't want it to be jaded. No, you know what I'm talking about? I don't want y'all to be like, oh, Book, you tripping, nigga. Like, I want y'all to get it out.
I know when Book come with a topic, he got a quick, he got a story that go with this shit. I'm gonna let y'all know, Greg, if you don't excuse me 1 second, I'm gonna go and knock this out.
Oh, go ahead.
On I don't know what it's called, but like not your chest, but the bottom part right before it gets to your balls, we can wax that.
The happy trail.
We can wax the inner legs and all that. We can wax all that. Ball hair, like hairs that's on my balls.
We're gonna get some
clippers, or we're gonna do something. You're not gonna wax my ball hair. I'm willing to go the extra mile for everything else. But what I would do if my woman asked me to do that, first off, y'all know I'm Lord Finesse. They should call me Lord Finesse. That's gonna be my new name, Lord Finesse. First, what I'm gonna try to do.
Somebody already called Lord Finesse.
Yeah, but I'm taking his name. That's my shit.
All right.
What are we gonna do? I'm gonna get that razor, that sensitive razor. I've been seeing people talk about Manscaped. I'm probably gonna get a Manscaped, and I'm gonna shave up real nice. It's gonna be real good. It's gonna be it been what 30 minutes since I shaved. Ain't no stubble gonna be on it. I'd be like, hey babe, I did what you wanted. Now tomorrow, when she figure out, hey, stubble back, hey bitch, I got you. You hear me? you should check a little bit better. You hear that? You got no vibrator in the bathroom. You hear that the whole time? Shit, chop that shit up. Hey, but great. That's where I'm coming from, man. How you feeling, bro?
See, man. You kind of told you said my answer for me. I'm not doing it because. Your second response to the stubble going back, and you're going to be out, you know what I'm saying? You ain't going to get enough for a minute. So I definitely ain't going to do it, man. Like, nah. Like, we just, I don't know, foreplay, something. Or, I don't know.
But
something.
That's what your woman want. If you want her to do the same for you, why would you wouldn't do it for her?
I mean, I probably would do it, of course, but I don't know, man. That stubble thing, I mean, it ain't gonna help nobody. I ain't gonna get none. She gonna be hurt. Like, what are we gonna do? You know what I'm saying? Like, every real time. So I feel like my woman, and not no disrespect to any other woman, but she enjoys it so much, she wouldn't even have that request. You know what I'm saying? Because she know the stubble gonna come back. And then it's going to not be there. So, nah. I don't think she would request it. I hope not. I hope she hears this too.
So, let me get this straight before we move on to bookstore. You saying your woman enjoys the bush?
To my bush?
Nigga, yeah. Who else we talking about?
Yeah. I mean, I don't.
70 porn. You know. Okay.
Ron yeah. Jeremy in this bitch, you know what I'm saying?
I'm telling you, for real.
I am Bushwhacker.
Watch out now.
Okay. Greg got that.
It's okay. It's okay.
Greg got that. Greg got that. That beard right down below too. You heard me? She like the beard, boy. She like the niggas with the beard.
The secret's out. The secret's out. You know what I'm saying?
My bad, Greg. Where you get in trouble, man? My bad.
Nah, I'm good, man. She knows all fun, man.
Nah. Right, what you got, Book, man? Tell a story, bro.
Okay. Oh, shit. All right. All right. So, you know, I manscape my regions, right? You know, gotta do the head because I'm baldy like that. Did the face, I'm Tech Nine like that. You know what I'm talking about? Sometimes with the armpits, you know what I'm talking about? I don't like a lot of hair on my body. I'm not a hairy individual already. But I just like to be, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't like walking around and, you know, with wifey, I see her hair every damn where. You know what I'm talking about? Falling off her hair. And I just think that's nasty as shit. But when I'm walking around,
I said that's ladies for you, man. That's how.
Yeah, I think that's the most nastiest shit ever. Like this is your body just laying on the ground, like, and you just want me walking on it. You know what I'm talking about? It's on my socks, and I don't even know. Now I'm in the bed, and I got hair that just crawled up to my face and in my pillow, and it's, you know what I'm saying? Like, why the hell don't you pick up your shit? You know you said. You know what I'm talking about? You know you said. So. But I hate when I walk around, and for me, I tell you, I ain't got to visualize nothing, but, you know, when you walk around sometimes, like, you be out the shower, okay? You might have just dried off, but you want to just let your whole body get that cool breeze, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, the next day, I might be walking around, and I don't know if that's a hair from up here or if it's from somewhere else. And I'm just like, oh, you know what I'm talking about? So you got a manscape, okay? So for me... When it happens, you think everything is like, oh, hey, they go your pube. I'm like, everything's not the damn pube, okay? Everything's not fucking pube, okay? It could be from my chin, it could be from my stag, it could be anything, all right? But one day, she was in there doing her little wax stuff, right? She got a little own kit just for, like, you know, the small touch-up areas that she likes to do. So I was like, that ain't shit, okay? Now, I hadn't skated yet. Hadn't manscaped yet. Mm-hmm. All right. It's Manscaped Monday. It's usually when I do it.
Manscaped Monday?
Yeah, Manscaped Monday. Yeah. You know what I'm talking about? I got to set it aside. Brother, got to get right. Got to get right. So, got to maintain. So, she's doing the thing, and she's like, ah, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, you've done this plenty of times to where that shouldn't even bother you. And you do your thing. You see what I'm saying? When you get your legs and all that other stuff, whatever else, whack. Mm-hmm. You should be used to that. That's baby. You know what I'm talking about? So she was like, well, how about I try it on you? I said, try it where? So I was like, it depends on, you know, the location. So she was like, well, I won't mess with your front. How about your back? Not my back. Talking about my back, bottom back. Okay.
Not so, your booty, nigga.
Yeah, the booty crack. Gotta get my booty smooth.
Wow.
So, I said, oh, Lord. Okay.
Because I was like, okay. You know what I'm talking about? Okay. I was like,
how's that going to benefit her, though?
It don't. It don't. That's not a benefit. It was just like, let me see if I can take the pain. You know what I'm talking about? Because I'd be looking real crazy from somewhere that I'm going to see every fucking day, and I'd be looking crazy. You know what I'm talking about? Like, I wouldn't want that. Mm. So I was like, okay, well, I'm thinking my ass, you know, area is a little bit more, you know, strong for the for what was about to happen, right? So I'm nervous the whole time. She was like, okay, drop your jaws, lay on the bed.
You exercising the muscles out of
something? No, I ain't exercising. Oh, no dips, no squats, no nothing, nigga. But I'm thinking it's going to be a lot less sensitive.
Wow. Okay?
Because, you know what I'm saying? Like, the stuff that leaves your body, I'm thinking that my ass muscles are strong like that. You know what I'm talking about? Like, it can handle this balance. So she's like, okay, take, you know, lower your underwear, lay on the bed. I'm like, okay. Now, I am clean, y'all. It's not funky hiney or nothing like that. I'm clean. I'm clean out the shower type stuff, all right? So she was like, all right. So she goes to the microwave and warms up the wax. I was like, oh, shit, you going to put that hot shit on me? So she got this little, like, this little wooden spoon shit that you be seeing people do with honey, like that type stuff. Or when you go to the doctor office, Greg, you know, they put that fucking, that wooden thing in the jar.
Oh, yeah.
One of them. So she's over
there.
Go
on your ass?
Yeah, I see the hot wax just dripping down. I'm like,
oh, you shit.
I said, okay. So she was like, all right, now I need you to hold your ass open. I was like, oh. I said, Suki, don't play with me. Don't you play with me. I swear for God, if you play with me, I'm telling you now, I'm gonna punch you in your fucking mouth. Do not play with me. So she's like, I'm not gonna do nothing. Just you gotta hold it open. I can't do it. And I'm like, I don't wanna do it. I won't do this. All right.
So
I was like, God damn. So she was like, you ready? I said no. So I let my butt cheeks go. I was like, I don't wanna do this, right? So he was like, come on, stop being a little pussy. I'm like, okay, first of all, you ain't gonna call me a little pussy. So I spread open again. I'm like, do it fast. You know what I'm talking about? So she applies to one side, right?
Hold up.
Bro, don't ask it. I know
who you are. Nah, the podcast need to know. Somebody need to ask this question. How was you bent over? Was you bent over with your booty tilted up in the bed? Or
no, I'm laying down. Like,
was you like this? What are you doing out here? Why are you doing this? Why are you doing this out here, bro?
Oh, Lord. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, man. Wow. So you was laying down with your booty tooted up in the air.
I'm not like my whole body on the bed. So, you know, like the ledge of the bed. So my legs is on the ground, but I'm leaning that way, right? So I had to like slide back a little bit because, you know, the legs are long, so I had to slide a little bit. So it's really just like
using doggy style, basically.
If you want to put it that way. Yeah. I guess so.
Suki put you in doggy style, man. Shout out to Suki for that, man.
Wow. That's a boss move right there. That's a boss move. You know what happens is, you know, so I'm spread, so she applies. And I was like, whoo.
Suki said, I'm the captain.
Huh?
Suki said, I'm the captain.
Yeah, boy. She wore that goddamn day, boy. I couldn't fight that. I'm a lieutenant right now, boy. Lieutenant Dan on that ass. So,
man. That's funny, man.
He puts the wax on and it's hot. I'm like, God damn. I was like, blow that shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's shit hot. So she was like, hold it. Don't close it. You know what I'm talking about? I'm like, so she gets a little wax paper, right? She puts it on. So she was like, okay. She was like, just hold one side now, the other side, not the side that I'm on. Just hold that. That way they don't touch together. So I'm like, okay. Boy, she said, you ready? She said, on three. She pulled on 2.5. Okay. So she was like, one, two. And I was like, ah! I jumped up. I said, no. We done.
She did one. Okay. You got to do the other side. You're going to be looking locked.
No. She said, you still got wax, though. You still got wax. I'm like, I don't give a fuck. It's done. We done. It's finished. I don't want it no more. I tried it. No. It's over. It's over. I will never do this ever in life. So ooh. I'm like, Now, if my ass was that sensitive, ain't no way we making it around to the front. So,
you right about that?
Oh, I ain't waxing nothing. We just gonna be a little stubby, okay? We just gonna have some stubble. That's about it. I'm gonna get it as clean as possible for you. You know what I'm talking about? And I'm not gonna come in here looking all crazy. But I'm like, I don't know how they do it, bro.
That's crazy, man.
I couldn't even. Oh Lord Jesus, hell bro, no.
Nah, man. I know my boy ain't got one.
To her skills, though.
I know my boy ain't got one smooth ass cheek and one hairy ass cheek.
It was out there like this. Oh, Manscaped Monday. I went and did my own thing. You know what I'm talking about? My special clippers that I got to the side for that area. You know what I'm talking about? But it was just like so sticky because the wax is so, it's the wax is wax, nigga. Like that shit, something different. So yeah, it's like melted bubble gum stuck to the bottom of your shoe. Like it's, but my ass was just like stuck together. I'm like, yo, this is uncomfortable as fuck. You know what I'm talking about? I don't like this.
Oh man.
Oh, that was my story.
Next topic, man. Leave this one alone. Next topic, bro.
Okay.
This bro said, dude said he got what ass waxed. That's crazy.
I also want to know is,
boy.
That topic sponsored by Dope Music Entertainment.
Shout out to you, AB. I don't think he want no parts of that one. He might want you to take a hoodie off that second.
Really? You know, funny, music, man. You do it on wax, nigga. It's a double entendre right there, baby. You feel me? All right. Well, the last one that I had for y'all was, you know, when you encounter these women out here. You know, we've already talked about the transgender community, so this isn't a transgender question. But it's along the lines of that. Being fooled by the women, all right? What I mean by that is, you know, it's all about appearance. And how do you combat the fact that you might have called a woman a man on accident? Why? The way that they dress. We know all not all women are equipped the same. You know what I'm saying? But some of y'all do dress like men. Some of you straight women dress like men. Some of you straight women have these manly haircuts. Okay? And I slipped up. And I ain't know how to get it back. You know what I'm talking about? So that's my question.
You just let it go. You let it go.
I had no choice. I didn't even try to correct myself. But that's the whole thing is, if you accidentally call a woman a man, should you really feel bad about it or not? Now, like I said, it's all about the presentation. And if you do feel bad and you're, excuse me, what did you say? How do you get out of that? What do you do?
But let me take this one, man. This lady has one of them, you know, them little hover around things. They be riding around in the VA, you know what I'm saying, going like 30 miles per hour. So she got all these stickers on there or whatever. You know what I'm saying? They need to slow their ass down. It's a hospital, you know what I'm saying, first and foremost. It's a hospital. And they be looking at you like you wrong when you try to, you know what I'm saying, not get hit by the – anyway, that's another story. But this lady, you know what I'm saying, she and I didn't realize it until she rolled past me. Like, she has a bumper sticker that says, like, I'm a girl, I'm not a man or something like that. And I was like, oh, excuse me, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just said it just like that because she was going fast. So I was like, oh, excuse me, man. And, like, she kind of looked like, you know what I'm saying, like, hands on the wheel and looked. And I'm just like – and, like, she was looking at me like, obviously, this nigga did not see my bumper sticker. You know what I'm saying? So I was like – and, like, I just let it go. Like, all right, well, my bad. But she had a buzz cut. You know what I'm saying? It was an older white lady. She had a buzz cut. She had, like, a tank top on. She had a sports bra. You couldn't – you know what I'm saying? And – she had no teeth, so I just thought it was an older white dude. So, and yeah, but to answer your question, but nah, man, I mean, obviously she knew what she was doing. She wanted to be, you know what I'm saying? She wanted to try to confuse us at the VA. That's her fault.
And if she got to put a stick on her hoverboard or the scooter, whatever it is, like, that already tells me that you paint the picture that you don't know what you're doing.
That's
what and
I'm
you
saying. Got everybody that's else the perception. Here. Yeah, you want me to be in question. And
maybe that's a way of getting you to talk to her too.
I don't know. Maybe so.
Maybe that's the gateway. You know how some people will drop something on accident and wait for you to pick it up, spark a conversation. Yep. Maybe that's how. Oh shit, Greg.
I don't know.
She ain't gotta take the dentures out, bro. You ever felt what them gums feel like, nigga?
I ain't trying to, bro.
Boy, you ain't got no gums on your. Me neither, but I'm saying like. I could just imagine. No teeth? Oh, my God.
Man, she looked at me. Like, she turned around so quick. Like you should have been seeing my bumper sticker. Like, nah, I didn't. I'm sorry. You know what I'm saying? That thing big, too. I think it was, like, yellow pink or something. Said, I'm not a boy. I'm a man. No, I'm a girl or something. Said. I was like, oh, shit. My bad.
That's funny. That's funny.
So, yeah, man.
Man, I think we all had them kind of situations, man. And me working for the post office, man, I go to people's doors all the time. I mean,
yes.
I've had whole conversations with women and didn't know. I guess they was like, I was like, how you doing?
Man. Yeah.
How you doing? I was like, I'm doing good. How you doing, sir? Oh, I'm doing good. Yes, sir. I'm saying all that shit. You know what I'm talking about? Yes, sir. Can't be bad, but I feel good out here, sir. Yes, sir. I mean, I said,
wow.
Sir. I was having man so many times. And then when I leave, you just act like you ain't know. You just act like you ain't know. You're
that's it. You just got to take that L, man. That's how you do. Yeah, man.
I mean, for real. They had one for like 2 days straight. They had a certified letter. I was like, okay, yes, sir. That's what's happening. Thank you. You know what I'm saying? You have a good one, man. That's what's happening. Same thing the next day. 2 days later, I guess she said, fuck this. She came to the door with a sports bra on. I was like, oh. How you doing?
Oh, wow.
Oh, shit. I didn't even know how to say it. I got a certified.
You
know what I'm saying?
Can't say it. Yeah.
My bad. You're my bad. I ain't even gonna say what I was gonna say, man. Go ahead, but go ahead.
Well, for me, you know, at work, the face-to-face interactions, when I don't know, I can kind of piece it together because you're not going to come up to me. Like, my job, you have to speak first, not me. I mean, I'll greet you, but you have to tell me what you need. So I can kind of go off of, once you start talking, I can kind of hear a difference a little bit. And if I look at you for long enough, I can tell, all right? Phone call is very tricky. I had about a 5-minute conversation with this lady. Okay. She never told me her name. She just said that my manager gave her my number to call me and ask me about customs and what this, that, and the third.
So I'm like, all right, cool. The whole time, I was like, hey, man, how'd you get my number? Because it was my personal number. I was like, hey, man, how'd you get my number? Mm-hmm. And he, at the time of my thinking, was like, oh, your manager gave it to me. I was like, that dude know better to give out my personal number for some work. I got a whole work cell. You know what I'm saying? I was like, please, don't be giving out. I was like, okay, when you leave or you need somebody else, please don't give out my phone number, okay, to nobody. So I gave him, thinking in my mind at the time, my email.
Mm.
Now, I say, email me your stuff, your paperwork, so I can review it. When that shit came in, his name was Catherine. So I'm on the phone still because I'm like, don't hang up until I get it, man. Mm. You know what I'm talking about? Like, the whole time I'm asking an ass word. You know what I'm talking about? So I was like, and at the end, I was like, I tried to make my man and ma'am sound alike. I got it, ma'am. Man, wow, man, hey, that'll work. You know what I'm talking about? I never called you a guy. You know what I'm talking about? I said, I had to give my number, ma'am. You know what I'm talking about? Like, if you listen back and you start to double thinking, I'm like, oh, he did call me ma'am. Maybe I thought he was calling me man the whole time. Nah, he was calling me man. And I was like, thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. It was a whole lot of ma'ams after that, though. Like, yes, ma'am. I say sir like that, but yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Wow.
But I had that one. But the one that really prompted this was I was at the DFAC on Wednesday. And this person was at the ice cream little dispensary, right? I was out there getting sweet potato pie. I ain't supposed to be having it because I'm on my diet type shit. You know what I'm talking about? But I was like, you know what? I deserve a cheat item. Not a cheat day, not a cheat meal. A cheat item. So I was getting sweet potato pie. I don't really like sweet potato pie like that. I prefer apple pie, okay? So I can put that bitch in the microwave, warm that up, and then put my vanilla ice cream on top of it. Like, I like to eat it like that. So, but they didn't have that. They didn't have apple pie. So I was like, okay, I'm going to get sweet potato, and then I'm going to get, you know, a scoop of vanilla ice cream. Knowing that I'm lactose intolerant, I know what it's going to do to me. So my cheat meal is actually a benefit because it's going to flush out everything. So I'm going to get a cup so she could put my ice cream, the hostess, waitress, or, you know, the person in there. So there's this individual by the cups. I was like, oh, what's up, brother? You had the same idea as me. As I'm grabbing my cup, now I said brother. I said brother.
Wow. All right?
By the time I turned and I looked at her in the face, I just kept turning and walked away. There was no way for me to. I can't clean that up. I was thinking my whole time. I was like, I don't say nothing. I was like, I wanted to say my bad. I didn't say shit. I just walked away. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I didn't feel bad. I felt bad more or less that I said brother without knowing or really analyzing the situation. But like, it was like everything was lined up. She had on baggy ass pants. She had on a loose button up, and she had on like a Miguel type haircut. Not now with the perm, but like when he first came out type shits, and I'm like, or Chris Brown, like a Chris Brown right now, and I'm this guy right here, this, what's up, brother? Like, oh, you another? My bad. I'm walking away. I couldn't fix it. So I didn't know how do you play stuff off like that, or like if you've actually been approached by somebody that literally like was like, hey man, I'm a woman. I'm a female. Like,
you did the right thing.
If she would hit me with that, I'm like, well, I apologize, but you don't portray yourself to be that. Like, it would have been worse. You see what I'm saying?
Nah, you did the right thing.
Okay. Yeah, right I keep it moving, man.
Definitely would have kept it moving. I
paid for walking.
I wouldn't have came with that old ass nigga slang, though. Hey, brother. That's what, you know what I'm saying?
I call that hey, brother. Brother. God daddy, yeah, all that.
You jamming on the one with the ice cream. You know what I'm saying?
Boy, that's crazy.
Let's go to this power recap real quick, man. I want to get this out the way. Greg, you seen Joker, right? You seen the Joker?
Yeah, I saw Joker.
That's good, because after the power recap, we're going to go into the Joker, man.
Me and P saw it.
That's good, because I got a lot to say about the Joker, so I want to get this power shit out the way. Power was trash. Anything y'all want to say?
Nope. Yeah, just set up the segue for – go ahead, G-Money.
Nah, I agree. It was – that episode could have been like – I don't know.
It was necessary, I guess, for the next what's coming up with Power.
Because
at least Tariq is going to know the right way to deal drugs and stop bullshit. Mm-hmm. That was the only significant thing I seen in that whole episode to me.
But that was like the last 20 seconds of the episode.
Yes.
Literally.
Yeah, I know. Yep.
Definitely.
Yeah.
I wanted Tariq to get shot in the fucking face, man, when Ghost. I wish it was loaded, though. That would have been so awesome. If it was at least just one bullet in the chamber, that way he would have took it a lot more serious. Like, why would you go in there, fake like you're going to shoot him with an empty gun, and then lead a gun like he don't know how to look and see if it was loaded? I think it would have put more fear in him if you actually had just one bullet. Mm-hmm. Just one. You know what I'm saying? And what would have made it real crazy? If his name was actually on the bullet. Oh, God. See, they need to incorporate me into writing, because this shit sucks right now. If you would have had Tariq on the bullet, boy, they say bullets ain't got no name. This one does. You see what I'm saying? It's made just for you. I think that would have been dope. Tommy, he hanging him over the banister. Like, he did tell him, like, I've killed niggas for less. You know what I'm talking about? But he should have did something more. You know what I'm saying? Should have did a little bit more, but I don't think that he would actually physically, like, hurt Tariq.
He's not gonna do that.
Yeah, but I was just like, I don't know, man. It was. I could have missed this. I could have missed the week and just been just fine, just fine. Or
I like went to the bathroom. I was doing the stuff around the house, man. I was asking Patricia. I was like, "What's going on?" She was like, "You ain't watching this one." I was like, "This one is lame." Like, no, I'm not watching this.
So. I'll tell you like this. That episode of Power, I was tired when I was watching it, but while I was watching it, it put me to sleep.
Yeah.
That one was weak.
Yeah, ain't got nothing to say about that Power. That was weak. I want to get to the Joker. This is the time. Everybody that has not watched the movie, I need you to turn this podcast off now if you intend on watching this movie. It's going to be spoilers. It's going to be all that. We're giving our review of this movie at this point. So turn this motherfucker off, as you have been warned. We're going to talk about this, because I got a lot of stuff. I want to see if my fellas caught this shit in the movie.
I got a lot of questions that I've been holding on to for over a week because I was waiting on everybody else. So.
Let's start. First off, I want to see just real quick, how do you rate the movie? You know what I'm saying? I just want a quick rating. Greg, how you rate it, man?
What, numbers or letter?
What out of 10?
One out of 10? Probably like a 8.
8 out of 10.
Yeah.
What'd you give it, Buck? What'd you give it?
I'm going to get that thing because, for me, like I told you, I'm not an advantageous follower of, like, the comic origins or anything like that. So, for how the story was crafted for me, it was beautifully done, beautifully scripted, well portrayed, and even better so was a provocative performance by I'm forgetting my guy's name.
Joaquin.
I didn't mean no disrespect. Yeah. So by Mr. Phoenix. So for me, I'm gonna give that bad boy an 8.7.
I gotta throw
a decimal in there. 9 to 10.
8.7.
Yeah. I'm gonna go 9 because you got 9 on your shirt. We just gonna round up. You got your Drew Brees on. I'm gonna go with a 9 out of 10. I loved it. I ain't gonna lie.
And what I'm going to do is...
Yeah, it was a good movie, man.
I'm going to give it a 10 out of 10. And I think you guys will understand once I tell you guys some of the stuff I know you guys probably missed on this movie. What are some of the questions you had on this movie, man?
Okay, so without going into anything, we already know he's a patient, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It starts off, he's talking to a counselor, things like that. Mm-hmm. Towards the end, you know, when he finds out about Thomas Wayne and his mother, supposedly Penny had this affair and you're the child and all this, I'm like, okay, that's a different spin for me because from everything that I've seen, that hasn't been the storyline that you was like related to the Waynes in any capacity, whether it's true or not. Okay. So, you know, they're saying that your mother was crazy, you know, delusional. We had to let her go. She was in this, blah, blah, blah. So, you know, when he goes down to the psych ward, to Arkham Asylum, and he gets the records, you know, it says that she didn't see things clearly. You know what I'm saying? I forget the medical term that they have for it. But she's delusional. All right. So towards the end, okay, after all of that, then he starts to see how he was going on his dates and the girl really wasn't there and started to fade out. So I'm like,
yeah,
okay. Okay. Then after that, you know, mental breakdown, it's like towards the end. Now, after that, I don't know if any of that shit really happens. Okay. Because at the very end, when he's talking, he's now in a psych ward, okay, and he's talking to somebody, and then I'm just like, nigga, did you just dream this whole fucking thing up? And
you caught what the fuck I caught the whole movie.
I'm like, is this like his, was this his trial? You see what I'm saying? Like, was this him thinking it through? Like, okay, these are the pros, these are the cons. This is what could possibly happen, like, because you've always been an outcast. But at the end of your dream or your illusion, you know, you're celebrated, you're heralded. You see what I'm saying? Look amongst the masses as a savior of sorts, a hero. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just like, nigga, what the fuck? I'm sorry, like, I was lost. I was so lost. And that is the question that that has been bothering me and plaguing me. Like, nigga, was this all a dream? I used to read Word Up magazine, Salt-N-Pepa and Heavy D up in the room.
The best thing about this movie is if you see it, the gradual, like the first time he had the flashback was when he was in like the studio with the guy. He was acting like he was on the show with the what's dude name? I forgot his
Robert
name.
Robert De Niro.
Yeah, Robert De Niro. Robert exactly. De Niro. Like he was on the show with him. Gradually through the movie, it was like it gradually showed you somebody losing their fucking mind. Because reality and his mind blended together so well, you didn't know what was real and what was not. Also, the first time he went and sat with the counselor, she said, "You remember you was in the psych place first, and he saw him in there banging his head against the wall." That's why I go back to what you said, but I think none of this shit actually happened. That's what I think. I think the whole movie was him talking to that lady and saying, trying to get it off his chest. That's why the lady at the end resembled the lady through
at the beginning.
At the beginning.
The only thing, her hair changed up.
She was looking at the same lady. It's just like 20
she even
later?
Looked the same. The hairstyle changed. Matter of fact, her hair looked more modern now. I think what it seemed like was Joker's in Arkham right now, and they was like, "Tell me how this happened." And he was telling his story. That's how I took it at the end. It was like, "Tell me how this happened." And at this time, he was telling himself, and he was trying to get sympathy. Like you being the audience, you didn't feel sympathy, but you felt understanding of what happened. And I think that's what he was trying to get across to this lady. But at the end of the movie, I think he just showed this nigga is just crazy as fuck because he went prancing around after killing the therapist lady. You know what I'm saying? I think that whole movie was not a movie. I think it was him lying the whole fucking time because you couldn't understand what was the real and what was the fake. And that's why to this day I like villains. I don't think you are a credible hero unless you got a credible villain. And I like that's why I got Thanos in here, I got Killmonger. I love the Joker. I don't know if y'all remember a couple years ago I made a 2K team and it was the Joker. I love the Joker as well. I love the villains. Whenever the villain is credible, then I can take the hero serious. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So if you got just a bullshit ass villain, man, don't nobody care about who the hero is. That nigga ain't shit.
But nah, you're right. That's true. That's just like in wrestling. You know what I'm saying? But like, we knew.
The only thing I want to say, I don't know if y'all caught this, but when he was in there at the end putting that makeup on his mask and he put that shit on his tongue, when he pushed that picture out the way, on the back of that picture it said, "Oh, I think you're so beautiful," or whatever like that, and it said TW for Thomas Wayne.
I didn't see a picture.
Mm-hmm. It was a picture when he was up there putting that makeup on his mask. It was either before or after he killed that guy with the little scissors or whatever, and then let the little short guy go. That shit was funny. They had a picture that he got out the way, and on the back of that picture, it said something about "You're so beautiful. I think you're great." Huh?
Okay, for me, there's the stuff that I was not seeing because obviously where I'm at now, was this picture in his notebook?
Picture was in the house.
Okay, the stuff in the notebook. Whatever I can kind of figure out what it was. Probably like I can't see that. It's blurred out over here. So it was like several things that I'm like, I don't know what the hell it is. I can kind of pretty much envision it, but
he had a picture and it was quick. It was quick, but he had a picture. His mom had a picture with Mr. Wayne, Thomas Wayne, and on the back of the picture, it was real quick. It said, "I think you're so beautiful." It said TW. I think he actually is Bruce Wayne's brother. And I think that Thomas Wayne
got that paper. That's wild.
And said, that's why I think it was so brilliant in doing that, because it's why Joker has such an infatuation with Bruce Wayne with the Batman. Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? For me not to have an origin story, that's perfect. And even that little gem
it don't even matter, though, because I know the original story. And I thought it was fantastic.
In my opinion, I mean, it was just so original. And like I said, genius, like, in doing that. Like, I was asking myself in the movie, like, why haven't people done this before? You know what I'm saying? Like, they could have, how many Joker movies, how many has it been? What, one, two? I mean, not, but like, with the character.
But he's
like,
been portrayed easily,
Yeah,
you got Jack Nicholson and what's up, my guy?
And Heath Ledger. You know what I'm saying? Heath Ledger.
Pete.
Yeah. Easily. So I think that was real brilliant. And then my only thing.
I don't count Suicide Squad.
I don't count that. I mean, he was okay. Yeah. He was okay. But like just how it just really referenced like to what's going on today. You know what I'm saying? Like how the world is. Like that was my thing that I really was like, okay, this is, you know what I'm saying? This is real. You know, and it really wasn't, it was one of those movies where it was a Joker movie, but like it's just a really, really good movie. You know what I'm saying? Like beyond the Joker. Like you could have put another name on it, you know what I'm saying? And it just be the movie by itself. And it probably would get better reviews or something. You know what I'm saying? You know how hardcore DC fans and whatever, but it's a really good movie, man.
You know what I saw, man? What you got, Franz? I'm gonna remember what I'm gonna say.
Okay, I just think, like you said, I know the origin story, and it came out of this book right here called The Killing Joke, Batman: The Killing Joke, right here. If y'all want to know his original origin story, is in this book. I didn't even care that he had an original origin story. I think this is the first time I think I've seen somebody remix something and it was actually better than what I originally had. I thought it was super dope.
Yeah.
The movie, just like I said, it gradually showed a motherfucker losing his motherfucking mind.
Losing it.
And I thought that was so unique to this shit. That's why I got to go 10 out of 10, because I thought the movie was damn near perfect. I don't see nothing else I wanted out of the movie.
Like, even with the laughter, how they made it into a condition. Like,
yes.
Bro, I thought that was brilliant. Not because he was trying to sound sinister. It's just something uncontrollable. You know, like a Tourette's. You know what I'm saying? Like, got a card and everything. Yeah. I have a medical condition that causes, you know, compulsive and, you know, impulsive laughing. Like, I can't stop. So even when he's laughing, it's and he's shaking his head. I thought that was, like, dude, everything about... I'm sorry. I'm giving it A+. I keep going up. It's the upper room. Like, nigga, we going all the way up. Yeah. Like, all the
it's
way
funny
up.
You say that, because I was thinking, I was like, man, I got to go up too, man. Like,
I can't shortchange this movie, man. I hate to. The one thing I don't like to do, that's why I say 9 is like typically the highest I'll ever go on a movie, which means it's perfect for me. You know what I mean? But I'm not going to shortchange it. We're going to go 10 out of 10, like you said, Franz.
The only reason I say 10 out of 10 is because I don't want nothing else from this movie. I'm good.
Oh, it's beautiful. It was beautiful.
Yeah.
It was beautiful. Even, bro, I'm talking about even when I ain't supposed to be laughing, I'm laughing. You know what I'm saying? And it's not a funny movie, though. Even at his bad jokes, I'm laughing at his bad jokes, because it's like, this nigga can't stop laughing because of his nervousness.
Bro.
I'm laughing before he even gets a word out. You know what I'm saying? It's like...
People don't get it.
Mm-hmm. So I thought it was brilliant, man. And then even at the end, like when he finally gets his shit dolled up, like you said, from after he actually kills the boy, powdering up the face and greens the hair, and he's dancing on, like, nigga, like you seen it in the trailer, like when he's dancing on the stairs and shit,
mm-hmm.
you know, all that. But when the two cops at the top, and then nigga was about to do the pump action. That nigga was cutting the rug, boy, on the stairs.
He was getting it. He was getting it, man.
Leaving. I was like, I'll do it after everybody clear out. You know, he was at the top. And I need the lights to come on. And I don't want everybody laughing at me. So I did it. Actually, I didn't even do it in the Joker movie. I did it after we saw Rambo. I did it on the stairs there. So I was like, got my Val Venus on and did all that funny shit he was doing.
You know what make that movie so good?
What's that?
Is that 2 seconds after he brutally murdered somebody with some scissors and banged their head against the wall.
Bruh.
2 seconds afterwards, when the little short guy tried to leave the house and couldn't touch the lock. 2 seconds after, you forget he killed somebody, and you be like,
"Yes, yes,
okay, that's funny right there." And then he iffed at him. He was like, he's like, "Nah," like that was pure Joker right there. Like,
that was good shit. That was good shit too.
The movie, it was nothing else I could have thought of somebody doing from the Joker. And what I'm not liking is somebody they keep on rating, like, okay, it's Joaquin Phoenix better than Heath Ledger. I think
they had two different type of roles, man.
Exactly.
Two
different roles. I think Heath Ledger was the fully realized Joker.
Yes.
I think it still fit in that same world.
His potential of
exactly. That's what he gets to. That's what it means. Joaquin Phoenix was the beginning. Like,
yes.
Okay, he's going to be weak right now. He was weak. He was weak in the other origin story. Of all the origin stories, he was a weak dude. And then he got pushed to that point, and he broke, and he got crazy. So I can't – it's like 1A and 1B. You know what I'm saying? I watched the movie one time. I'm still going to give Heath Ledger the 1A, and then 1B right next to him is Joaquin Phoenix. Fuck the
I ain't going
to
give him a B. I'm going to go one capital A and one lowercase a. They both 1A. You know what I'm talking about?
Man.
Same letter, just one a little bit bigger than the other. But yeah, and I think I would probably give Heath Ledger the edge only because of I got Batman and him at the peak of what it was. Because that movie is bar none just fucking great.
Man.
That movie is also a 10 out of 10.
That's a dope ass
movie. Oh, yeah.
And that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Now, online – you know how people just be posting shit. They had the nerve. They was like, we're going to rank the best, the worst to the best DC movies ever. Okay? Suicide Squad was the top. Yeah, you was trash ass. Yeah. I ain't worried about it. They had the nerve. After I had just watched this movie, they had the nerve to rank Joker number 22.
Huh?
Exactly. Number 22. They had Aquaman above it. Aquaman, hell no.
That list trash already. You ain't gotta finish it. The list
Check it. Now going in. And this is, I was like, okay, well, I already know what number one's gonna be. Dark Knight. Okay? That's mine.
Oh, that's everybody's.
Yeah. Easy.
Not this list. So Dark Knight was like number 12. I said, well, what the fuck? Hold up. Now, the original Batman with Michael Keaton, that's the best Batman ever.
He is the best Batman. That wasn't the best Batman movie, though.
No, that's what I'm saying. Like, he's the best Batman actor. I said that. Mm-hmm. They had that movie ranked number 18. So I was like, okay. But then they had Batman. Mm. What's the second
What is one and – let me get one and two. What is one and two?
What do you mean?
The best one. What is the best first and second one movies?
Number – shit, I can't remember. They had Supermans in there also. Man of Steel was higher than that one. I remember number one, though. Number one was Batman Begins.
That movie, trash.
They had that as the best movie.
No, that was the worst one out of the trilogy.
Thank you.
The first one? Yeah,
the first one, garbage. It was the second one with the Joker, and then Bane was a close second. That movie was hard. Bane was hard. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Bane was tight on that.
He was going to work, boy.
Man.
Boy. Yes.
What he said? What he said? He said, he said, you play in the dark, I live in it, or some shit like that. That was like the hardest line ever. I said, oh, shoot. That was, man, that whole little
Batman out of retirement, right, boy. Like, yo.
Man, when he broke his back.
Bruh.
Man, I see the light coming up on book, man. Let's go and get up out of here, man. What y'all ratings is, man? The last time on the Joker, man. I know y'all was going up. Yeah. I'm gonna go because I think the Dark Knight is so good. Man. I'm still going 10 out of 10. I'm 10 out of 10 on it.
You can't never not just have two 10 out of 10s. You know what I'm talking about? But this is like literally that shit, bro. Like, I'm all the way in, bro. I'm all the way in with it.
What you got, Greg?
Man, shoot. I
got no complaints.
I started at an 8. I'd probably say 9, man. Because I'm still, my affinity for The Dark Knight is just, I mean, but yeah.
Ain't nobody mad at that, though. Can't nobody.
Yeah, I give it a 9, I would say I give it a 9.
MTV movies, I remember when it's all transition, it all worked. The little boy, he was talking to Robert Downey Jr. And it's MTV Movie Awards or whatever it is, Moon Man's. They was talking about how Iron Man has such huge success, the first one. Mm-hmm. And the boy was like, talking to Robert Downey Jr., he was like, well, yeah, your movie ain't going to be shit once The Dark Knight comes out. I remember that to this day. And I didn't know, like, I was like, yo, Iron Man was lit for me, bro. And I was like, yo, this is fire. And then when that Dark Knight came out, I was like, yeah, your movie ain't compared to that.
You know how good The Dark Knight was? The Dark Knight made everybody forget that Heath Ledger was in Brokeback Mountain. That's how good that shit was. I forgot all about,
right about
the lasting image, man.
And
I don't remember no other movie. I know he was in a movie with Mel Gibson, The Patriot, I think.
It don't even matter. None of those matter.
None of that matters. Only people remember is this. And that was lasting impression. Like, rest in peace to him. You know, sad what actually transpired. But, man, did you ever give a performance, my brother?
Never seen Brokeback Mountain, but I know the stigma behind it.
Yeah.
And I forgot all about Brokeback Mountain.
Mysterio.
And I ain't gonna lie to you until I heard somebody say a review, and it was talking
about Mysterio's
in
it.
His two,
Jake Gyllenhaal.
You know what I'm saying? He's talking about two memorable performances from him was Brokeback Mountain and this. I said, damn, I forgot that nigga was in Brokeback Mountain. You know what I'm saying? So, hey, shout out to Heath Ledger. Shout out to Joaquin Phoenix. Two GOAT legends of the Joker. You know what I'm saying? Y'all, Jack Nicholson is not up there with y'all. Jared Leto should never happen. He was a trash Joker.
He had a grill. What the fuck? Get the hell out of here, man.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
And also, what's my dude? What's my dude name? I can't remember. He's one of the best Jokers of all time. He played all the cartoon Jokers.
I know you're talking about. Yeah, I can't think of his name.
Can't
remember my dude. All the animated Batman movies.
Right? He do them all.
Yeah.
Mark Hamlin. Mark Hamlin. That's his name.
There you go.
Hamlin. Shout out to Mark Hamlin.
He's good.
He's real dope. He also played Luke Skywalker. What's his name? Yeah, that's who he played.
Yeah, Luke. Uh-huh. Yep.
Yep. Oh, yeah, that's who played the Joker on all the cartoons. Shout out to him.
Oh, good shit there.
He's the best Joker, if we going to rate him. It's him and then the rest of them. It is what it is. The cartoon made more of an impact on my life than everything else. So, hey, I got to go with that. Greg, you got anything before we get up out of here, man? It's getting late.
Nah, man, just real quick, man. Just this. I don't know. Just like that.
Yeah, I got you.
I don't know. But it's just the whole month of October is Mental Health Awareness Month. I know they had like a day yesterday, and just talking to my therapist, you know, she was just like, yeah, just get it out there. You know what I'm saying? So that's pretty much it.
Dope.
Okay. Yo, what you got, Book?
Once again, brought to you again by Dope Music, ChosenMusicians.com. Going to get your merch, okay? Shout out to you. ChosenMusicians.com. Go on and get your merch. That's it, brother. You know, supply and demand. Demand is there. The supply is given. Holla at your boy. That's all I got.
Make sure y'all subscribe. Make sure y'all click that bell. You know what I'm saying? Get all the notifications when we drop. Also, make sure you follow us on all our platforms. Make sure you hit us up if you want any of our merch or any of our shirts, stuff like that. Matter of fact, just reply under the videos. I'll holler at you and we'll get you some stuff out there. You're hurt. Right. It's going to cost you because I'm not sending that shit out for you for free. I mean, hey, I got to make some money too.
Might cost you a lot.
But it's going to cost you. You know what I'm talking about. Okay. If there ain't nothing else, man, we go out the book. We might need a new dancing video from you. You might have to do the...
I might do a Joker, nigga.
You might do a Joker dance. I mean, I don't know. We going to see.
Joker dance and JJ ice fish that bitch. You know what I'm talking about? I got you. I'm cooking up, bro.
Let's shoot, man. Until next time, man. Hope y'all enjoy. Y'all peace out. Peace out. All right,
see.
Pray for me. Pray for me. Do everything.